I just thought I'd give you a little tour of the alarm that I just recently installed in my vehicle. It's just a cheap one off eBay. The link's in the description. It's basically, first of all, my start on the doors. These are the slimline solenoids. The thicker ones wouldn't fit in the Beetle. Then, go along here. Some extra cable there, just in case I wanted to do something in here. Then, come to this bit. This bit right here is a bit that we added in. And it's just some plastic sleeving with the cables inside. A hole drilled out there. And then that's the hole where the door hinges are. And then that just goes through. And the cable's going to go through as well, from the little gaps around the side. Another thing is, with the alarm, there's also electronic boot release. That's also in the description. It's also manual, and it's also on the alarm as well. So, yeah. That's that working there. Not a lot else really in this side. Right now, onto the driver's side. Similar setup as before, exactly the same. Right, we had to modify it. It was just basically bring this bit out, which we'll be painting over again. But that's not important right now. It's got five cables rather than two like the other side, because this lets the alarm know that it's locked or not. I've unplugged it for the moment, so I can do this quickly. Goes around again and back up there. So the place where I installed the LED for the alarm to let everyone know that it's got one, and also to make sure it's armed, is all the way up here. It's hot glue gunned in, and then all the cables run down the wing, or the pillar, sorry, and then go down to the command module that's in there. That's pretty much it, really. There's no modification that really needs to be done at all. Check this out. So yeah, just glue gunned in. The standard light still works. That's the switch side. That's another important thing. When you are installing this alarm, make sure you have the courtesy door switches, which are down there and down the other side. This is letting your alarm know that the doors are shut. And also, it means your lights work as well, which is pretty good. Obviously, you've got to make sure you've got the three-prong switch as well. Some of them don't have them. Yeah. Another thing I should note as well is that the indicators come on when the doors are open, so that you know. This can be turned off, and yeah. There's lots of different programs you can function, like auto-locking as well. That's something I need to turn off. It's quite simple to do, they'll come with a manual. That's in English-Chinese, so everything's a bit out. Right, this is the solenoid working, so it's unlocked at the moment. Lock. Unlocked. Locked. Unlocked. Don't ask me why the alarm went off. I don't know, but oh well. I think it's because the doors were unlocked. But this is the keys. Nice little flip-up cover. Aluminium, looks smart. Yeah, pretty nice. That's mainly the reason why I chose this one, because it was so good compared to the cheapy other ones. But yeah. Right, now onto the front of the Beetle. Down here. This is the module here. As you can see, there's quite a few wires, LED, output, stuff like that. Also power cables, negatives, solenoids, boot release, window winders as well. If you've got electric window winders, you can connect up to this. And you can change the timer in the program, so it can be 2 seconds roll up or 30 seconds, depending on what you want. The only problem with the alarm at the moment that we've got is the wire for the boot release coming off the alarm can't take the power of the solenoid for the boot release. So one thing we're going to have to change is put a relay in, something like that. One thing that I did with this was the negative for the ignition is somewhere around here. I don't remember which one it is exactly. I think it's one of the big ones. It's black.
So it's probably one of them. That we used as a relay for the immobiliser, so the ignition and the electric fuel pump this has got won't work at all. That's changed your fuel pump because it broke. Mounted the solenoid for the cable all the way down here. Then down there, put it upside down. But I flip it over. So that there is the solenoid, which is mounted. Got two screws there, which will be painted over very shortly. Just haven't got around to doing it yet. That's it really. I've got to ask how long this took. It took quite a while actually. Started on a Friday and then did a couple hours then. Then also most of Saturday, a little bit of Sunday doing it. And then an hour and a half every night, and I've only just finished now and it's Thursday today, so it took me almost a week. So if you are planning to do this to your car, then obviously take a bit of time doing it. It's going to take a bit of time, so you will be out of a car for a couple of days. That's if you do it properly, of course. You could budget in and it could take you a day. But didn't really want to be stranded at the side of the road with the car that didn't work, so thought I'd do it properly. That's it, really. The horn has to be different as well, because on the alarm it switches positive, and on the horn of the car it switches to the negative to the body through the switch on the horn on the steering wheel. So the horn is mounted somewhere underneath there. Probably can't see it, so I'll put a picture in. Yeah, that's it. Really? Not what else to mention. Got any questions, just ask me. Is it really? We'll be right back.
to be at all.